welcome. You're with us here on The Money Show, the only show of its kind, India's first and only, which brings markets' top financial experts to answer all your financial queries. I'm Abha Bakaya. Let's get started with the topic for today. And joining us on the show is Harshvardhan Roongta, CFP with Roongta Securities. Harsh, great to have you with us today.
My pleasure.
And we've actually got a very interesting topic lined up, particularly in light of the latest AMFI data that's also come in. What would you rather do, invest a lump sum when it comes to mutual funds or in your investments, or invest in an SIP? What's the better route? Well, let's take that question to Harsh. Harsh, this is something that so many investors are always asking about, and particularly as there has been so much talk about SIPs being the right way to go, they're also more accessible, so on and so forth. How would you weigh up the pros and cons between the two?
Abha, when you look at two concepts of investing, one is that you're trying to compound your money. So you invested and you want to start your money, to make your money work from day one. On the other hand, there's a concept of rupee cost averaging, especially when we're talking about investing in equity markets. You have to understand the markets are going to be volatile over a period of time. So we're not going to look at a scenario where it's only going to go up, consistently going to rise at a particular rate of return. Like an FD, a fixed deposit would every year give you a 6 or 7% return. So the graph would only linearly be going up. In equities, that does not really happen. So if you're investing as a lump sum, you have to very clearly understand that you're parking your money at one shot into the market. And if the markets start moving up from there, then you will continuously make profits on the entire capital that you've invested. Now, in case you are able to handle that volatility, you have to understand that equity markets will not only keep going up, they may also at one point come down and then again go up again later on. So this is a cycle which will keep happening. If you understand this entire concept of market volatility, you have a long-term view with your investments and you're comfortable with this kind of volatility, not only understand it but also be comfortable with it, then you can choose to invest as lump sum. The advantages are clear. I mean, if the markets go up over a period of time, you will make more money because your money has already been deployed from day one. Now, contrary to this, as Abha, you also pointed out, that there is another concept of accessibility. You know, we're talking about SIPs being popular because people do get money every month in the form of salaries or business profits, which they deploy as per convenience as well. So besides the convenience part, when you invest via SIP, the entire objective is that because markets are continuously moving up and down every month or every day rather, you're investing at a regular interval so that you keep averaging your investments over a period of time. So rupee cost averaging is one a clear advantage when you do it through SIP. Now for those investors who are not confident or who are not comfortable with volatility but want to have equity as an investment in their portfolio, choose to invest via SIPs. So so that they keep averaging over a period of time. The compounding factor really comes in a little later because the entire capital has not been invested. There is some part of your money which is lying outside the equity ambit, and once it comes into getting invested, only then after that the returns start generating over it. So very clearly there are two distinct advantages and disadvantages.
Today, as per the AMFI data, the rate of growth in SIPs or in flows into mutual funds from retail investors, for example, was slowing. Does that worry you, or how would you allay investor fears, especially a lot of first time investors who put money in the market and then had their fingers burnt? And it's not a new problem, but I think in recent times, especially in the last few months, we've seen that. How would you allay their fears and convince them that if you are particularly going through an SIP, for instance, you can ride out this storm?
So this is a classic example of investors coming into equity investing only because they've seen past returns. Now, if you come in looking at only last 1 or 2 years data and feel that the equity market is going to do the same thing every year continuously, that's not going to happen. So last 1 year has been painful for even SIP investors. If you look at the SIP portfolio, returns have also been negative. So if you and the numbers have gone up only in the last 1 or 2 years. So very clearly there are new investors who come in the last 1 or 2 years and they have still not seen profits in their portfolio. So now being disappointed with that, obviously you will see numbers dwindling now, because returns are not good. The moment returns start showing positive and higher returns, then again people start coming into it. So what you need to understand, if you're an SIP investor, if you're an equity investor for that matter, you do not look at returns only from 1 or 2 years perspective. You have to have that faith in the markets that India as an economy will grow, and which will reflect on the equity markets over a period of time. So you have to continue investing. That's the essence. Had you known markets are going to go only one side, which is upwards, you would not invest via SIP. You will invest directly as lump sum. You will sell off everything that you own and invest in markets. Had you known that the markets are only going to go up one side.
Absolutely. All right, let's get to our queries then. We've got Ibrar Khan who's written in and has asked, is it safe to invest 50,000 in a 100% equity mutual fund? And if so, please suggest some names for a lump sum investment. So clearly he's going the lump sum way. What would you recommend?
I just have a concern particularly about the query. So if you just understand the query, and unfortunately we do not have Ibrar with us online. So if you just understand the query, it says that is it safe to invest 50,000 in 100% equity fund? Now this exactly is a question which an investor should not be asking. So your question is it safe to invest 50,000 in equity funds? And if you're investing in equities, you must understand the underlying rules of investing in equity is that it's going to be volatile. So equating that with a question calling is it safe, I really don't know how to interpret that kind of a question and align it with the market volatility. The second element of investing in equity is that you need to be invested for long term. Because in the short term, you will find volatility, you will find, the markets going up and down continuously. And I don't know if you can call it safe in that sense. Mm-hmm. Nevertheless, I understand, if you just have to assume.
And safe is an interesting word to use when it comes to these investments. As per what Harsh was also saying earlier, market volatility is difficult to predict. So you have to be prepared for a little bit of a rough ride when you do invest.
Absolutely. So in any case, assuming that you can, Ibrar, have both, you understand market volatility, you want to invest as a lump sum and you can stay invested for long term. Putting all these three things in perspective, then it is relatively appropriate. I would not use the word safe, but I would say it is appropriate to invest in a 100% equity mutual fund. Now, if that is, you fulfill all those criteria, then you may split this money into two parts and invest as 25,000 each into two schemes, which I can name out to you. IDFC Nifty Fund is one that you can pick and invest 25,000, and the other is an ICICI Multicap Fund in which you can invest the other 25,000 rupees. Now, having invested in equities, having invested in these two schemes, review this performance and this portfolio after 2 years and then take corrective steps if needed, otherwise just continue with it.
All right, hope that answers your question, Ibrar. Let's move on to our next query as well. And we have Rakesh Kumar who's written in. He says he's invested a lump sum of 6 lakhs in ICICI Pru Value Discovery Fund in December 2016. Wants to know whether he should hold on or redeem his investment there. What would you suggest, Harsh?
Abha, if you look at the performance of ICICI Pru Value Discovery Fund in the last up to 3 years from today, it has been an underperformer in its own category, and even when you compare it to the benchmark, it hasn't really done well. But if you extend this, the timeline to about say 5 years or beyond that, it has been one of the best performers in this category and also when compared to benchmark. So now you're in a peculiar situation. Last 3 years haven't been good, but otherwise in a longer period, it has still been one of the best performers. And if you look at, dig a little deeper into the fund house, into the fund manager. So Mrinal Singh is the fund manager. He's done well with equity, so maybe this is just a phase in which you're finding the performance not being as good as peers and benchmark, which is a cause of concern. We don't deny that at all. But looking at the fund house, the research capabilities, the overall structure, everything put in together, I would say keep the faith on, continue investing in it. And what you could definitely do, because you are a lump sum investor with 6 lakhs at one shot, you may want to review this performance once in 6 months. So in two blocks of 6 months, have patience for another 1 year. What you can do is, after 6 months, look at it again. If there is any improvement in the performance when compared to peers and in the benchmark, then it's fine. If it's not, then wait for another 6 months. If continuously over a period of 1 year, which is two periods of 6 months each, it does not do well, then you may at that point in time think of moving to another value-oriented fund or a diversified equity fund. So that call, I would give the benefit of doubt for another 1 year to ICICI. And you can hang on till then and then take a decision after 1 year now.
All right, we also have a caller joining us. Krishnamurthy has dialed in from Bangalore. Krishnamurthy, good evening. What can we help you with?
Hello, good evening.
Good evening. Go ahead, Krishnamurthy.
Madam, I have got 4 SIPs. Parag Parekh long term equity, 2000 rupees SIP, 15 years.
Okay.
Kotak balanced advantage from 1000 rupees, 12 years SIP. L&T emerging, 1000 rupees SIP, 15 years. Sundaram Services Fund, 1000 rupees SIP, 18 years.
Okay.
So I want to know how these funds are, and this is for wealth creation.
Sure. Since you've already invested in these, any sense you want to give us of the performance you've seen of your investment so far, Krishnamurthy?
No, I have invested 6 months back only.
Okay. All right.
If you look at the portfolio, mm-hmm. I mean, it's not really an ideal allocation that we may look at. So, if these are the only four schemes that you have in your portfolio, then well, I wouldn't recommend a Sundaram Services Industry Fund that you're talking about. L&T Emerging is fine, Kotak Balance Advantage, Parag Long Term is fine. I think there is a scope to change the Sundaram scheme that you have to a large cap fund in which you can add an Access Blue Chip fund or an SBI Blue Chip fund. I think that is the only one change that I can recommend at this juncture, but otherwise it looks fine. So do make that one change and then stick on with your portfolio for some more time before you review it again.
All right, hope that answers your question. Let me also bring in Ramakant, who's calling us from Agra. Ramakant, good evening. How can we help you?
Good evening, madam. I am a senior citizen and want to know whether balance advance fund are suitable for SWP or lump sum can be invested. If yes, please recommend some funds.
Did you get that?
Yeah. So, I think Mr. Ramakant, you are asking about the balance advantage funds. And I believe somebody has recommended to you to invest the lump sum at retirement into a balance advantage fund and take an SWP so that you can meet your regular monthly expenses. This is what you've been advised and you're just cross-verifying whether that that process is good or bad. I believe this is what your query is, right?
Yes.
Okay. When you talk about financial planning for senior citizens, it's a very important, phase in life. I mean, it's a completely different step. I cannot really look at just one scheme and suggest whether this is the best thing for you to do or no. This philosophy on investing in a balance advantage fund and taking an SWP may not be wrong entirely, but it could go extremely wrong for you if this is the only investment that you're dependent upon. You understand what I'm trying to say? I'm saying that this may not be a bad situation. However, if this is the only investment that you're dependent upon, then it might not be a right thing to do. So when you're talking about, just take your example and also address the larger audience at once, is that whenever you're planning to invest for retirement, do not look at only one product and evaluate whether that is good or bad for you. You need to put this product in conjunction with your total financial planning. What are the other investments that you have? What is the other source of income that you have? Are you only dependent on this income out of this particular product, or this is only going to supplement something else that you have in your portfolio? So that is the holistic approach that you should be taking for planning, not only look at one single product. So if your question now very strictly asking you is, I have invested in balance advantage fund and I'm taking an SWP route, is that a good thing or bad thing? Well, I would say at this juncture, it's not a bad thing to do. I really don't know whether this is the most appropriate thing for you to do or not. So I hope I've answered your query, though not completely, but I have my limitations in not being able to answer this query in totality. But I think I've given you a fairly good idea on what you should be thinking.
All right, let's take a very quick break. On that note, we'll come back with more queries answered by Harsh, who's a writer with us on the show today. Back in just a moment. Welcome back. Times Network and the Association of Mutual Funds in India have recently launched Jan Nivesh, an investor education initiative that is getting people to pledge to invest their one day's income into mutual funds for long-term benefits. You too can be a partner of the growing Indian economy by investing in mutual funds. Join the Jan Nivesh movement and give a missed call on the number on your screen, 1800-833-666, to pledge to invest a day's income into mutual funds. Harshvardhan Roongta is still with us and we are taking your queries on The Money Show. Sai Kiran is calling in from Bangalore. Sai, do share with us your query.
Hi, thank you for giving me an opportunity. Good evening. Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
So I'm thinking from a long-term perspective and I want to stay invested for 10 to 15 years. And I'm thinking of putting in about 5,000 rupees every month starting in SLP. I want to play it safe, hence I'm looking for a large cap fund with a fund house that has got a good track record, some good old fund houses like HDFC, ICICI, SBO and stuff like that. So can the expert kindly recommend some some good large cap funds, please, for an SIP of 5,000 rupees.
All right. Well, couple of interesting things in that question. He mentioned the words long term.
Long term, so a fund house with a track record and
amazing. Yeah.
And a large cap fund. So, well, Sai, you've got most of the, you know, the check mark, your tick marks into your checklist. Mm. So, in that context, well, is to start with a large cap is a good thing to do. I'd only recommend that you split this 5,000 rupees into two different schemes. The first one being a passively managed large cap. So, I'll recommend an index fund to you. It's a low cost fund which invests directly and replicates the Nifty 50. So, you know, it's easier to track, and you know, over a longer period of time, we've seen that in a passively managed funds do tend to outperform more than 50% of actively managed funds. So, 2,500 rupees can get invested into IDFC Nifty fund. This, as I mentioned, is a passively managed index fund. The other 2,500 rupees, you mentioned SBI as one of the names that come to your mind. So, you can pick an SBI blue chip fund. If you like an ICICI, you can pick an ICICI blue chip fund, or an Axis blue chip fund is one of the three schemes that you can pick up. So, I've given you one passively managed and one actively. Amongst the actively managed, I've given you three names: the Axis blue chip, ICICI blue chip, and an SBI blue chip. So, you can pick any one of the three, whichever you're comfortable with. In this way, you will have your 5,000 invested into large cap funds, and for a period of 10-15 years, you can definitely continue with these.
Good luck with your investments there, Sai. Let's also bring in Arun Bindra from New Delhi. Arun, what's your question today?
Hi, good evening, ma'am. Thank you very much for picking me up in this show, because I tried for a lot of different shows and this is the first time I'm getting through to any of these kind of mutual fund shows.
Awesome.
As far as mutual funds are concerned, whatever the information I got or whatever the knowledge I have is through these shows only, especially on PT. I am investing from last 4 to 5 years in mutual fund, and I think the funds which I picked up through your channels only, that is also for long term, as well as I'm doing a SIP plus this is for equity only. I have a couple of funds with me and I wanted to know if these funds are good or do I need to switch to some other better funds, because as we have just seen also from last 1 year, mutual funds are not giving good returns.
Share the fund names with us, Arun, and we're always happy to help. So, we're glad that you called in today.
Thank you so much, ma'am. The fund which I picked up is Aditya Birla Sun Life India Next Generation Fund. I have a DSP Small Cap Fund. I have a Franklin India Opportunities Fund. Okay. And I have a HDFC Top 100 Fund. So, as of now, DSP and Franklin is giving me a negative return.
Okay. All right. Well, given the volatility we've seen in the markets over the last year, it's perhaps not so disturbing if some of the funds are performing a little less better than the others.
Yes, absolutely. So, if you're just looking at the last 1 or 2 years' performance, of course, you don't need to be disappointed. We've already spoken about this earlier, saying that the returns of even in SIPs have been negative in the last 1 year. So, if you're talking about just 1 or 2 years' performance, then don't be disheartened. I mean, just continue investing in your SIPs. With coming to you specifically to your portfolio, well, what you're disappointed with is a DSP small cap, and there is one scheme of Franklin, which I didn't get the name clearly. But in can we have the name?
Aaron, what was the name?
Opportunities Fund.
Franklin India Opportunities Fund.
Yes.
Okay. So you're clearly disheartened with these two schemes, and you know, if you're looking at a small cap, you must know that last 1 year and 2 years, in fact, have been extremely painful for small caps. So, if you do not really understand a small cap, do not have the risk appetite for a small cap, don't be invested in a small cap. It's a simple, you know, equation as that. So, I can recommend two different schemes in place of your DSP small cap and a Franklin India Opportunities Fund that you have. So, in the place of DSP small cap, again, you know, stick to a multi-cap fund. That would be much better for you, because they would also have a small cap exposure, but not an entirely 100% into small caps. So, you could choose an SBI Magnum multi-cap fund. So, this is one of the schemes that you can pick, which also has a small cap allocation, but not entirely 100%. It invests across market capitalization, which is large, mid and small cap. So, you can do that. And in case of a Franklin India Opportunities, you pick up a Franklin India blue chip fund. So, you're within the fund house, but just that you're picking a large cap fund. And so, in that context, you will have a portfolio which is of a multi-cap, large cap. You have another large cap in HDFC Top 100, which is an ideal portfolio to make. You really want to keep the core portfolio into large caps and have some exposure in mid and small. And Birla, the next gen, you can continue. So, I think these are just two small changes that you can make in your portfolio and invest here on.
All All right, fantastic. Hope that helps, Arun. We're running out of time, but before we do that, I want to get Harsh's view on a particular fund today, and we've picked up the Axis Blue Chip Fund. Let's get Harsh's verdict on this particular one, and again, why you think it rates well.
So, you know, as the name suggests, Axis Blue Chip Fund invests only in the large cap companies. But the definition of large cap is that you pick the top 100 companies in terms of market capitalization. That is the AMFI definition of large cap. The scheme has been investing only in those large caps purely. The other part is, ever since it has been into existence, which is Jan 2010, it has outperformed in all timelines. I mean, if you look at you know, just 1 year returns, or 5 years, or 10 years for that matter, it has outperformed in all those timelines that we're talking about. So a 7 year time period, because it launched in 2010, if you look at 17 18 years, up to 2017 18, it has outperformed in all its peers and its benchmark. So another parameter is, it's not only consistently doing well, it's also outperforming. So when you put both of these together, this is an ideal you know, kind of a scheme that you would want in your portfolio. Something that has been consistent with this performance and has also been an outperformer. So one of the highly recommended schemes in the large cap category is the ICICI Blue Chip Fund. They follow a growth oriented strategy wherein they continuously look out for options for companies which have you know, the growth prospects in the long term. So I think this is one of the schemes that you can definitely include in your portfolio.
Well, it's great to see that people are thinking about their investments and thinking carefully about constructing a portfolio. Always encouraging. And if you have questions around that, just call in or write to us at any time. We'll be happy to help. Harsh, thanks so much for joining us on the show.
My pleasure, always.
That's all from us on The Money Show. Thank you so much for watching.